So far, we have been using multiples to estimate the enterprise value of a firm today. As I told you before, we can also use multiples to estimate a residual value for a firm in the future. Recall that the residual value is simply the enterprise value of a firm at a point in the future. So instead of applying the multiple to an income measure today to get the enterprise value today, we simply apply the multiple to an estimate of this income measure in the future. For example, recall the XYZ example we covered earlier. We computed the enterprise value as of year 5 using the perpetuity with growth formula. Instead, we could have applied the enterprise value to EBIT multiple to our estimate of XYZ's EBIT in year 5 to get an enterprise value of XYZ in year 5. Imagine the trailing enterprise value to EBIT for a comparable firm is 4. We multiply the 4 times the EBIT in year 5, or 6,600, to obtain a value of 26,400. Since we are using a trailing multiple and the EBIT for year 5, the 26,400 corresponds to the enterprise value as of the end of year 5. We would treat this 26,400 in the same way we treated the other estimate for the residual value. We discounted it 5 years to year 0 and added up to the present value of the free cash flows in years 1 to 5.